Hi and welcome. Nice that you're here. I wanted to explain some things about this second version of the Sequin shader. I've put a lot of more functionality inside of it, which I'm gonna explain both in Substance Player but also in Substance Painter, so bear with me. When you buy this file and you open it up in Substance Player, which is freely available at Adobe, you can actually create and export all the images that you generate with this shader. When you open it up, you will get this setting to start with. You see that the output size is a bit low, so I'm going to turn it up to 2K so you can actually see what's going on. So here you have like the same material as the previous one, only there's one thing that's different, and that there's transparency inside for the background. You can turn up this slider to get the background in again, and you can change the color if you would like. But I built in the transparency because I also wanted to play around and see if I can put a custom input in there so that you can actually work with images or stuff in Substance Painter as well to actually alter the pattern colors. Talking about color, when you look here, there's this color you can change. The last one is for the alpha channel and it doesn't work in this case, so it's not working, but it's showing up. I couldn't hide it in the interface. Same goes for these two sliders over here, where you can actually play around with the random colors inside the pattern and also with the saturation a little bit. Of course you can just manually change to a color which you like this for instance, and what you can also do now is change the thread color. If you look at this, let me change the count so it will size up a little bit. You can see that there is this thread on top of the sequence. And you can change the color here as well, so you can actually have like a black one. It's very subtle, but I did build it into the shader because I think it will break it a little bit more. Talking about the thread, you can also change the count over here, so you can have like a lot of them, or you can just use none. There's one thing that I would like to show you. There's also this sequin shape which you can use to actually alter the appearance of the sequin. So there's this, of course, the size of the hole in the middle, but I can also offset the hole. But when I do that, I change the thread to be always one, because that's a logical thing to do when you create a material like this. So it says three here, but it gets overruled by this offset hole slider now. So when I turn this back to zero, so it's centered again, you see that the threads are popping back in again. So of course there are several things that you can alter as well, like the count, which I showed you already. You can also dial in more roughness, so you get rid of the shininess. There's also this random value, so that you have more variation. And same goes for the metallic, so you can actually turn down the metallic or turn it up or create some more variation with these sliders as well. And there's also a slider for the thread, so you can turn down and get thread more shininess or turn it up like it's set. I didn't build in the metallic version for that one. And now for the interesting part, what you can do with the custom input is actually put a color input in there. So when I select this and I select an image like this bird, it says image sequence, because there are several images in there which make a sequence, but you can just cancel this if it happens to you. And you can see that the bird is loaded inside of the sequin pattern, which is pretty nice. But you can see, because it's a square image or a square shader, but the image isn't square, you need to change the scale a little bit. So when I go in here, you can see that it changes back to the size like the original bird. And let me up the Sequin a little bit so you can see it a little better. So as you can see now, there's inside of this pattern, there's this bird. And there's also this slider, the custom color input, which you can use to actually tone down the input image. Of course, there's also these functionality, which are the panning, so that you can actually change the position of where you would like the thing to go. There's orientation. Like I can turn it around 90 degrees, 180 or 270 to turn it up, put it, yeah, all the way around. So you can use this functionality as well. And you can also turn off tiling. But when I do this, it also changes the mass tiling. I couldn't break this, or I couldn't set it up the way that I would leave the other one around alone. I'm sorry. But when I load in like an alpha channel, I can use this to actually separate the whole material. So you, when you set it up in like a substance painter, you can actually work around this with masking and stuff. So now we have a bird and it has no background. I can change this and put it like this, so now you have like a fabric underneath with the Sequin pattern on top of it. Of course you can change the background color, like I said, to make it more appealing or to your taste. Now there's also the metalness slider for the background and the roughness, so you can actually make like sort of a satin or another fabric. But I left the opacity slider in here because you might want to combine this inside of other things in Photoshop or in your texture work or in Substance Painter, of course. So these are basically all the things that you can use inside of the shader now, which is a lot more than the previous one. And I also built in some presets, so when I reset it to what it was, I can turn up, also why not 4K. There's some presets in here, and it's like this lizard thing, and what you can see here is that it's offsetting the hole, so it's a different kind of Sequin material. Also put in white, and when you look at this one, what I did is I turned down the metallic thing a bit so that the color is more white, more vibrant. But there's a lot in here which you can use to play around with or get started with. When you look at this one, you see this is based on the dress that I used for Jessica Rabbit in an animation, and also looks like the previous shader. So this is it for Substance Player, and next I'm gonna explain how the shader is usable in Substance Painter. Okay, so welcome in Substance Painter. I didn't import the shader just yet. It's in here. But when you want to use it, you do import resource, add resource, and go to the folder which has the shader. Hold on, this is not the right folder for me. So you have like the Sequin pattern V2 SBSRAR shader, and when you open it, you get like it's a fabric and it's a base material, and in this case you can load it inside of your project, but you can also put it inside your library, so if you want to reuse it in another project, it's there as well. I'm gonna cancel this now because I already have it in there. So when I select the material, I can just drag and drop it, of course, so it will create a fill layer with the material inside. Right now everything is a little dark and black. What I also would like to do is get a more neutral background, because it works better. You get a better feedback of what you are actually doing without colors interfering from the environment. So when I look at this, you have like the presets in here as well. So you have here underneath the parameters in the properties area, you can select like the ocean version or the Jessica version, or maybe we'd like to have the gold one. So now we have like this gold version, and you can see it's transparent. So we can combine this with different shaders or base materials inside of Substance Painter. So while talking about it, let's just do something with it. Of course, we can have like a denim underneath, but I will show you it doesn't work out of the box, and I'll explain later how to work around it. So now I put the denim fabric underneath. As you can see, we have a denim here. Let me change the tiling a bit so that it's more detailed. But and when I turn on the Sequin, you can see that it's not working as expected. So what you see inside here is one problem, which is that the normal or the height information from the shader underneath is coming through the Sequin, which is an unwanted result unless you're being creative and you do want it. But in order to get rid of it, we need to change some settings in the height. So when I go to the Sequin fill layer, you can change like the normal information and set this to replace, so that it actually keeps the whole height intact, or like a dominant height map, and it doesn't show the stuff that's coming from underneath. But we have another problem, which is that there is I see transparency, but I don't see the denim underneath. So there's something we need to do to change this. So I select this layer, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add an anchor point. An anchor point can be used in different situations to actually read out information from different layers inside of Substance Painter. This is a whole mouthful. And what I'm gonna do is create a black mask or a white mask. It doesn't really matter in this case. And under this mask layer, I'm gonna put a fill layer. So now I have a fill, and what you can see already is that the texture underneath, or the shader underneath, is coming through, but not in the way that we want it. But as you can see in this grayscale area of the fill layer inside of the mask, you can actually change the color here. So you can see what this does, of course. And when I go to anchor points, I can select the Sequin layer, and now it should be okay. Oh yeah, let me change the color to opacity. So now, as you can see, we have the denim underneath. It's still covered a little bit too much, but let's play around with the fill. When I see all this on their parameters, there is all the things that I showed you in the Substance Player as well. So you have like the color, randomness, the background, and also the material. So these are all the same. But what we can do with the custom input in here is put in image inputs. It's not underneath the custom input anymore, because Substance Painter changes the way this is set up, but it works the same. So we can change this to use a color input. So let's select something like, I don't know, like this gradient thing. And I need to turn up this whole thing here, so that it actually shows up. It's different the way it works in Substance Player than in Substance Painter, but there's always some tweakable things that you might need to adjust. So now we can play around with color, but we can also import images or use like an alpha channel. Like I would like to have like a pattern with a black and white, what's it called, card of clubs. So as you can see, this works pretty well. You can also invert it, of course, but you can also, what you can also do if you want to use more color, is add a filter and change this to a correct. Now I need a gradient, hold on, like this. So now we have like a gradient which we can use, so we can change the black to a sort of a white and the white to a red. I know this is not an official card color, but it's funny that you can actually do this. I can also turn this one to 2. So color 1 will be red and color 2 will be black, so it's more official. So you can see, you can play around with the color inside here. You can always import a texture as well. And you can also, hold on, I'm on the wrong one. Of course you can get this out of here. I can also use this as a mask shape. So if you want to have like a pattern with stars or something, I guess you can create these as well. So as you can see, it's pretty powerful in the way it's working together. So you can have a lot of creative freedom to actually generate all these sequins inside of a material or in a texturing project. Let me see if there's something I'm forgetting. Yeah, the tile, of course. You can create more tiles, and as you can see, as you go up in resolution, the sequins get like deleted. There is a sweet spot. Another thing that I should mention is when you use the mask shape and it doesn't give you the results that you're looking for, then you probably are using an image which has too much gray values, and the whites might be a little gray or the blacks might be a little towards gray. What it's needing is actually a black and white image. So this is what works best with the shader, otherwise it doesn't know if it needs to generate a sequin or need it. You need to think about it like it's a switch. And of course you can play around with this forever. So I can have like a different kind of things in here, like this pattern, or check. So notice that there were some nice patterns in here, like these kind of things. So as you can see, it's powerful stuff. And now, and of course you can change the color, and all, you have all the controls that you need, but it's replacing the color right now, and that's because I have the gradient here, so I need to kill that. So now we have a black version. But I can also have like a gold version. So yeah, there's a lot of stuff that you actually can use to change it, and it working and it works pretty solid. And these still have functionality, so you can go all out. So yeah, I think I basically covered everything that you need to know how to set things up with the anchor and the opacity in here, which is important. And you can load in like the custom things inside of the image input, so you can actually play around with those. Let me turn the timing down so you can actually see this better again. So yeah, thanks for your time, and I really hope that you will enjoy this shader, and I'm looking forward to seeing results made with these. Thank you very much, and I hope to see you soon.